Hey, Petunia, want to do something really fun?
I'm already doing something fun.
Well, this is an even more fun game.
If it's educational, I'm going to politely disagree.
Please! It's a perfect way to practice our knowledge of cell types and have fun at the same time.
I don't think that's as motivating as you think it is.
I'll buy you a pizza.
Fine.
Yay! I promise this will be so fun. So, I have this stack of cards here. You're going to draw a card, and then I have to guess the card.
Okay.
I can't look at it, don't forget. Okay, you know there are a lot of guessing games like this with celebrities and music and household objects.
Household objects?
Well, this is more exciting because it's cell types. So the guesser asks questions. The questions they ask have to be yes-no type questions. And the fewer the questions they ask, the better. But the guesser can only name their answer once. And there are only six cards total. A general, fungal cell, bacterial cell, animal cell, plant cell, archaeal cell, and a protist cell. Although protist is such an informal category, as I've mentioned before, if you consider a six-kingdom system, these tend to be the cells of the organisms in those kingdoms. But I prefer focusing on domains instead. You can also organize them into the three domains.
Is this all relevant to the game instructions?
Well...
Okay, question.
I love questions.
How come some of these could be a whole entire organism, but others are just one cell of an organism?
Great point, Petunia. To understand that, I must explain. Some organisms are multicellular. They're organisms made of many cells. And some organisms are unicellular, meaning they're only made of one cell. Animals are multicellular organisms. That means the animal, the whole entire organism itself, is made up of many cells. Now let's consider a fungus. Like a mushroom, this mushroom is an organism made up of many cells. It's multicellular. It's a multicellular fungus. But there are some fungi that are single-celled, meaning the organism itself is unicellular. Like yeast. Yeast is an example of a unicellular organism, fungus that consists of one cell. Our focus in this game is of the individual cell though. Each of these cards has one general cell on it. With that, let's start. Draw a card.
Okay.
So you have the card. You're familiar with what's on the card.
I think so.
Okay, does it generally have a cell wall?
That's different from the membrane, right?
Yes, remember all cells have a membrane. This is outside of the membrane. It's a protective structure. Does it generally have it?
Well, now your generally is making me nervous.
There are sometimes exceptions. Biology is full of fascinating exceptions. Think of my generally as in most cases.
Okay, sure. It's got a cell wall.
A nucleus?
Nope. I know that one.
Okay, I've narrowed it down, Petunia. That makes it a prokaryote. And there are only two in that card deck that are prokaryotes. Could E. coli be an example of the cell on your card?
Sounds like an app or something.
E. coli is a common type of microbe and one that can make you sick. It can cause food poisoning, for example.
Oh, then yes.
Bacterium. It's a bacterial cell. Fascinating cell type. While some can make us sick, I want to add many others are very helpful to organisms and ecosystems.
Yep, you got it. Good job.
Now I draw a card. Okay, you go.
Oh, is it that rectangle one I draw sometimes?
You know, Petunia, you have to be careful with that question. I see where you're going with this, but you know cells can have diverse shapes in all categories. We'll say in diagrams, yes, this cell is often drawn as a rectangle, mainly to indicate it is rigid as it has a cell wall. But consider the shape of a guard cell that might be found on an underside of a leaf. Doesn't have to be rectangular.
Plant cell.
You... don't want to ask any more questions? Like, does it have a chloroplast, for example? Which it generally will. Autotrophs make their own food, and autotrophic plant cells use chloroplasts to do that.
Nope. Hey, I only needed to ask one question, I got it. Guess that means I'm winning.
Draw a card, Petunia.
Sure.
Is it eukaryotic?
Does
it have a nucleus?
Yes.
Okay, then it is a eukaryotic cell, as that's a feature of eukaryotic cells. Okay, so the organism it makes up must be a eukaryote then. Next question, does the cell have a cell wall?
Pretty sure it's a no.
Okay, so would you only find this type of cell in multicellular organisms? Meaning you would not find this cell in a unicellular organism.
Pretty sure you said in your monologue before we started this game that these cells would only be in multicellular organisms. So, yes.
Animal cell.
Nice, got it. So here's the score.
That should only count as 3, because I had to clarify that it was a eukaryotic cell.
Not my fault if you choose to overshare.
This is a fascinating one.
Is it gross?
That's pretty subjective, Petunia. Some can break down dead and decaying matter if it's a decomposer. Definitely can't do photosynthesis. In fact, by consuming organic matter, another vocab word to know, it's a heterotroph.
Does it make up multicellular things? Multicellular organisms?
Most organisms a cell would make up are multicellular, but there are still unicellular organisms with this cell type too.
Okay. Well, don't really know what else to ask.
Keep the curiosity. You must be curious about this cell. How about you ask, does it have a cell wall?
Does it have a cell wall?
Yes, this cell has a cell wall, and the wall is made of chitin.
Oh, I remember that, because I could never pronounce it right. Is it a fungal cell?
Yes, and Petunia, that's such a great example of how you turned your mistake into a memorable learning moment.
Yay. Okay, 2 left. I'm ready.
Does it have a... Is it an autotrophic cell, meaning it makes its own food?
I'm pretty sure some of them can.
Oh, actually, both of the remaining cards have that possibility. Note to self, not a good question. Okay, is it a prokaryotic cell?
No.
Okay, so that means it's a eukaryotic cell. It would be found in a eukaryote. Considering what is left in the deck, it has to be a protist.
Yep.
Which is our category. Amoebas, like us, and paramecia, and euglenas.
Aw, Gus, that's you.
You know, if we had started with this card, it would have been really hard with this very informal group. Some make up multicellular organisms. Some make up unicellular organisms. There are heterotrophic protist cells. There are autotrophic protist cells. Some protist cells have cell walls. Some don't.
Uh-huh. Well, there's just one card, so I guess I'm done.
Wait, no, we have to finish.
But Pinky, we know what it is.
Please.
Fine. But you draw the last card.
Okay, go ahead. I'm ready.
Archaeal cell.
You didn't even ask a question.
I didn't need to. Anyway, I win. Had a great time. Pizza, please.
Archaea are single-celled prokaryotes that generally have a cell wall, though their cell wall is different from bacteria. Many archaea are extremophiles, but they don't have to be. Many also are not. And by the way, bacteria can be extremophiles too.
Pinky, this sounds a lot like not ordering pizza.
That's because we haven't gotten to the bonus round.
What?
I have here a chart.
Is this what you were doing all night?
So, in each row, look, empty boxes for you to fill in. These empty boxes were mentioned at some point in the video, so you may need to think back on our conversation. After you fill them in, I can check them for you, and you can use it to check your understanding. And here they are filled in. These are general, by the way, as there are some exceptions. If you want to learn more about cell types or the vocabulary here, you can always review these in our cell videos in our biology playlist. Well, that's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.